Hello everyone, I am Lord Shrivik and today we're gonna create the Granny Grand Floor! Yes, today we're gonna create the Grand Floor. In the previous video I told you that we're gonna create the Granny's First Floor, but I was wrong. This floor is called the Grand Floor. The First Floor is above the Grand Floor, so the First Floor we're gonna create in the next video. And now, let's get started. We're gonna make the color for the base. Last time when I logged into the game to take the screenshots for the reference photos, I saw that there is something called the nightmare mode. So I took the screenshots in the nightmare mode. So this creation might be a little bit bloody and scary. So let's just make the clay for the base. As you see, I'm just placing this clay on my sketch and we're gonna cut the shape out of it. We need a one giant layer for the base. We're gonna place it on the baking tray. As you see, the color that came from the conditioning is a little bit purple. I wanted it to be more red, but whatever, let's just it be purple. We're gonna paint it to the red later in this video. And guys, this video is brought to you by Squarespace. Squarespace is a great platform that helps you create domain, website and online store, but more about it will be at the very end of this video. And now let's continue with the Granny's Grand Floor. And now let's just prepare the walls. So we're gonna mix some of the gray clay with the white clay and we're gonna put this into the conditioning machine. We need a gray color for the walls, so let's just stick it into my sketch. And as you see, I just draw all the lines on this clay, and through those lines we're gonna cut using the long blade. We need three very long walls, two medium and two very short, that will be between the smaller rooms like kitchen, hall and living room, I think. Now I am cutting the entrances that connect the living room with the kitchen and with the other living room that looks like another living room. I don't know why Granny needs two of them, but whatever. Now we're gonna make the structure for the base. The base is from the wood, so we're gonna make just marks and lines through it. And when I'm doing this, time for questions and comments. I didn't have much questions this time, so let's get started with the first one. 900,000k boys celebration time. Yeah, it's almost 1 million. I'm so happy because of that, and I still didn't figure out what I will do for the 1 million subscribers. So guys, if you have any ideas, let me know in the comments. And meanwhile, we are creating the stairs that lead us to the first floor. And in those stairs, there is some kind of room. There are doors on the right side of these stairs. I don't have any idea where this leads us to because the doors are closed. Maybe there is some kind of closet or something over there. I have no idea because it's closed. If you know guys how to open this and what is inside, also let me know in the comments. And now we're gonna make the color for this door and for the other doors in the house. In the nightmare mode, everything is kinda red, so we're gonna need this color a lot, so I'm gonna store a little bit for the future. And right now we're gonna make the marks on the stairs and we're gonna make the entrance for the basement. So let's just place it on the sketch and see if the proportions are correct. And then we're gonna make the doors. These doors lead us to the basement. And when it's ready, we're gonna place it on the baking tray. And after it, we're gonna make the closet that we're gonna attach to this entrance. So let's just cut it from the normal block of clay. And let's attach the brown doors onto it and a little handle. And let's place it on the baking tray. Okay guys, so we started with the hall, so we're gonna make the main entrance for the granny house, the big door with few locks on them. So first of all, let's make the frames, let's make the texture of the doors, and now we're gonna make the locks. There is actually quite a lot locks onto those doors. There is something that looks like an alarm also, so we're gonna make this. This is the thing with the red dots.
And after it's done, we're gonna uplift it and we're gonna place it onto the baking tray. Okay, doors are ready. Now it's time to make something that looks like a candles or the lights. So we're gonna place it on the baking tray and then we're gonna make the table. We're gonna move to the other room that Granny keeps the Christmas tree, and this table we're gonna place the tiny handles to the drawers, and we're gonna make the legs of this table. We're gonna attach it to the table later when they will be baked. So let's just place them on the on the baking tray. And now guys, we're gonna make what it is. I have no idea. I know this is the painting, so let's just place a bronze light onto this thing and we're gonna paint it after the baking. And now guys, time for the Christmas tree. I know Christmas ended long time ago, but Granny apparently live in different world and she celebrate Christmas all the year. When I was in the game, I by mistake just found this Christmas tree, but in this creation this Christmas tree will be standing. So let's make some of the Christmas tree decorations, and we're gonna a little bit form this Christmas tree so it will look like the Christmas tree. And let's place everything on the baking tray what it's done. Right now guys, we're gonna make the windows. In this creation there are three windows, so we're gonna make them at the same time to just save a little bit of the time. And look at this, this is my trick for making the windows and it's not worked, so we're gonna make this manually. We're gonna place the gray crates or frames, I have no idea what it is. That's probably the crates, because no one can escape from the house. That's why Granny mounted the crates onto the windows. So when they are done, let's just place them on the baking tray. And as you see right now, I have a lot of waste clay, so we're gonna just turn it into one big piece of waste clay and we're gonna put it somewhere. And with that waste clay I'm gonna make something in the future. Like in the previous video I made a big changus from the waste clay. If you haven't watched that video, make sure to watch that video after this one. Chunga chunga chunga. And now guys, what I'm doing right now, I'm doing the lamp. We're gonna assemble it after the baking. And now we're gonna make the frames for the doors, and after it's done we're gonna turn it upside down and we're gonna make the other side, because the other side is looking exactly the same. Now guys, we're gonna make two walls that are between kitchen and hall, and hall and the smallest living room in this creation. Let's just place it on the baking tray and let's get started with the one of the shelves. There are two shelves in this creation that looks the same, so we're gonna make the first one. After it's done, as always, place it on the baking tray. And now let's make another painting. We're gonna paint it with dirt later. Actually we're gonna paint with dirt everything, because everything in this house is dirty. Now guys, the table for the kitchen, let's just make a texture under the legs. We're gonna assemble it later. And let's make the fridge. I think that's the fridge. It doesn't look like the fridge, but it's on the spot where the fridge should be, so I think that's the fridge, wooden fridge. And now guys, what I'm creating, I'm conditioning the brown clay with much more dark brown clay. And we're gonna make, now I know, we're gonna make the shelves for the kitchen. So there will be two, three shelves. Let's just cut the shapes out of it. And we're gonna make the doors for the shelves. They will be in the gray color. Let's just attach it to this piece of the clay. And let's do this with the other one. Let's make the gray handles. And after that's done, we're gonna make the sink. So that was pretty easy. These things looks exactly how it looks like in the game. It looks like balls. And now we're gonna make the microwave. Let's just make this thing and let's just place it onto the shelves. And you probably wonder, what is that thing that I just placed? When I was taking the screenshots, it was actually a piece of the Granny picture that you have to assemble in the basement. So yeah, we're gonna also make the hidden elements that you need to collect in this game. Now guys, we're gonna make another shelf. This shelf will be hanging onto the wall, and when it's done, let's place it on the baking tray. And now We're gonna make the plates. Granny have some plates, three plates hanging on the walls. That was pretty hard to make, I have to say that. And now guys, we gonna create the sofa and the couch for the living room, for the mine, for the biggest room in this creation. So let's just make and let's just place it on the baking tray. And what is next? Next is the shelf for the TV. There will be a TV, very small one, very old one, on this table. And guys, I just have an idea. Let me know in the comments, should I create the tiny granny for this creation? In the next video, of course, where I will be making the granny's first floor, because I made a tiny granny, but I put her into the granny car, into her car, in the first video of this series. But unfortunately, I can't take her out from this car, so I have to create a new one. So let me know if this would be a good idea to create tiny granny for this creation. And now guys, what I'm making right now, another lamp. Yeah, we're gonna assemble it later. And let's just roll this clay. This will be another shelf. So we're gonna make it the same way that we made the previous one. Let's place it on the baking tray. And now we're gonna make the tiny table in the living room. And after it's done, we're gonna make the wood supports. We're gonna stick them later. I saw something like that in this creation. And now the kitchen table, the living room table and the four chairs. But actually, as you will see later in the video, I just made two of them, because I made not that much legs for the table and for the chairs. So when they are done, we're gonna place it. And now we're going to the oven for 25 minutes. This actually takes all my space on the baking tray. And now is the part when I'm just disconnecting everything from the baking tray. Some of the elements stick very hard, so I have to use my force to remove them. And the next step is coming. We're gonna paint it. Guys, let me know in the comments, which part do you like the most? The clay making, the painting, or the assembling with the glue? Let me know which one is your favorite. And now let's just paint it with the red color. This will imitate the blue, I think, or the red dirt. Is dirt red? I have no idea. Yeah, let's just also paint the other side of this wall, and let's paint everything on this color. You probably wonder how I made this color. So I just mix some of the black, some of the red, and I just tap this brush in the toilet paper. And actually after that, on the brush I have very small amount of the paint, and with this small amount I'm just brushing everything. So let's just brush this Christmas tree, this door, this painting, these other paintings, the kitchen table, the drawer, legs for the table, commode for the TV, and the fridge, and the sofa, and the couches, everything. Okay, when it's done, we're gonna remove all those small elements from the painting space. And now the next step, the assembling with the super glue. So first of all, we're gonna assemble the walls and some of the elements. So let's get started with this table, with the chairs. This was really hard to make, because those elements were so tiny. And now guys, let's just assemble the other wall, and let's just cut it a little bit, because it came out a little bit too long. And the middle one, yeah, right into this place, and let's just secure it with the glue from the other side. Let's attach this shelf and this door. And guys, where this door lead us to? I have no idea. No, I actually know. This door leads us directly to the garden. Now I'm connecting the items for the table. We're gonna just place it over here. And one of my cats just came for the hugging. They sometimes just scratch the door of my studio, and they went just hugging. So why not? Let's just hug him a little bit. And now guys, as you see, we are cutting one of the cabinets, because it came too large. So we just gonna cut. And I know it's looking like a chocolate, but it's not chocolate, don't eat that. Let's just glue it to this wall. Now we're gonna connect the sofa to the small living room and the other elements like these shelves and this window. Now we're gonna take care of the kitchen, so let's just glue these shelves and the window to the kitchen. And now guys, we're gonna talk a little bit about the Squarespace. If you ever thought about creating your own website or online store or maybe a blog, this is for you. With Squarespace you can easily create any of those things because they have a lot of personalized templates for the categories like art and design, photography and so on. And also you can create a domain there, so it's all in one service to build your online presence. So if you are interested, go to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you're ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/lordchirik to save 10% of your first purchase of a website or domain. And now guys, let's see the final shape of Granny's grand floor. This is the long living room that I was talking about. Now what you see is the kitchen, the hall and the smallest living room, and let's just place the previous creation onto another. That's how it looks like so far, and that's it.
Check out the previous floors, basement and granny garage, and see you on Wednesday. We're gonna create the granny first floor.